We have seen many new advancements in the robotic industry in the past years. First, Tesla announced the Optimus bot, which will use the same technology as the self-driving cars to understand its environment and to learn new tasks. Then, Figure showed their new robot and all that it can do after just 1 year of development while using ChatGPT to learn new things. And finally, we have Nvidia and Amazon, which are also working on humanoid robots to help them in their huge warehouses and factories. But how will this change our lives? The Atlas robot from Boston Dynamics was doing backflips 6 years ago, and we still don't have a robot at home like in the sci-fi movies. How long will we need to wait until we don't have to clean our houses anymore? How long will it take for me to be able to buy one of these and start playing with it? Although it looks like this is still far, far away, we are really close to having an operational humanoid robot that can learn new tasks and do them for us at an affordable price. This will be like owning a car or a phone. At first, only the richest people will benefit from them, but in just a few years, everyone will have his own robot and wonder how were we able to live without them for so long. And don't worry about them replacing you at your job. Unless they pay you to do nothing, robots will only increase the amount of things we can do and the amount of opportunities we all have. In the same way as computers didn't leave everyone jobless, and instead, they allowed all of us to do whatever we wanted with them. These humanoid robots will make the future finally look like the future. We have seen humanoid robots for a long time. At first, it was only in the sci-fi movies, and we had them in a variety of options. From the ones that will try to kill all human beings in Terminator, to the loyal ones in many other movies. But all of these have more fiction than science. In reality, what we had was some prototypes that were fantastic getting views at YouTube, but not that much in the real world. Boston Dynamics teased us with a lot of spectacular movements and incredible abilities, but they never got these humanoid robots out of the lab and into our houses. They may be used on some very specific tasks, like in the military, as they can waste as much money as they want, but no one is going to pay tens of thousands of dollars for a robot that can only do parkour and that relies on manual guidance for every action. What we need is a humanoid robot that can learn on its own and that can be useful in a variety of tasks without intervention, and we are going to talk about this in just a moment. But first, we need to know where we are right now, because it's obvious that we are not living among intelligent robots that help us every day of our lives. So, who are the robots that are real right now? In what way do we use them? We have already mentioned some specific military applications and lab experiments, but if there is one place where robots are fully integrated, it's in factories and warehouses. And who knows better about this than Amazon? They have been using robots for years, but most of them are Roomba-like robots to transport things around or articulated arms to manipulate everything they need. But that's not all. They also have a few humanoid robots that are starting to be useful in a variety of ways. And that is the key of humanoid robots. They are not supposed to do every task better than any other robot. They are supposed to do most of the tasks that a human can do, but on their own. The idea is that we use them to do the things we need, so that we have more time to do the things we want, the things that we really enjoy. So in a big warehouse, we will always have a majority of robots dedicated to specific tasks, and a handful of humanoid robots that will do the tasks that the others cannot do. But this is still far away from the utopic future where I don't need to do the groceries or that the robot brings me something that I left at home. And for that, we need them to be autonomous, we need them to be able to learn on their own, and to be able to update via software in a matter of seconds so they can do a new task, like in the movie Matrix where Neo learns Kung Fu in just a few minutes.
Holy shit, I know Kung Fu.
And that's what Tesla and Figure have been doing lately, and that finally starts to look like a real possibility that we all will have one of these robots at home. Tesla has been working on this for the past 2 years, and the progress they have made has been amazing. They went from nothing to having a functional prototype that can understand its environment and that can learn new tasks by watching videos of someone else doing them. They also have all the manufacturing capabilities to scale this to a final product that sells millions of units every year. They are already doing it with cars, and these robots will eventually be cheaper than the cars they sell. They also have the factories to use them, to train them in real-world cases, and the software that they will use will be the same as the one used for the self-driving cars. So this is like a 2-for-1. Solve one big problem and get one for free. You just need the hardware to run it. They also have all the money they need and the expertise of more than 100,000 employees. Very few are in a better position to build something like this. But if anyone can compete with them, it's Figure. They are a company that is not even 2 years old and that is already doing some incredible stuff. They receive funding from Nvidia, Jeff Bezos and Microsoft, and most importantly, they are partnering with OpenAI to provide the software for the robots. They will literally put ChatGPT on steroids in these robots. They are already able to learn tasks on their own, they are already able to understand their environment and to make decisions based on the things they see and the sentence they listen.
Can I have something to eat?
Sure thing.
Figure is still a small company, even more so if you compare it to the resources that Tesla has. But they are run by ambitious and intelligent people, and they have a very capable team that in 18 months went from nothing to having one of the most advanced humanoid robots we have ever seen. They have a lot of drive to build this. They are a small but highly coordinated team that also has a lot of resources and that tries to compete for a market that we still don't know how big it will be. And that is possibly the most interesting part of all of this. What are these robots supposed to do? How are they going to change our lives? If you describe the internet, modern computers and smartphones to people 50 years ago and ask them how they think we would use them today, they would have never guessed about social media, about people making money creating content, about people having businesses online. It would be impossible for them to foresee all these things that this technology has allowed us to do. And the same will happen with these humanoid robots. We can think about the tasks we do now that they will do for us, but we have no idea about all the future applications that we still have no ability to imagine. But in any case, there are a lot of things that for starters they will be capable of doing that will free our time to do the things that we truly love. Who enjoys cleaning his house or doing the groceries? Which kid wants to be a night security guard when he is older? Who dreams about becoming an hotel receptionist? Maybe some crazy people, but most of us don't want to do these type of things, and those are the first things that these robots will do for us, the jobs and tasks that no one wants to do. Think about it, these robots could be sold for around $100,000. If you need a 24-hour receptionist for a business, then you need to pay 4 full shifts. You will be paying off the robot in less than a year. And there are countless of jobs like this that can be easily done by them. Jobs that nobody wants to do and that end up depressing those who have to do them. In the same way that before the Industrial Revolution, 90% of the people work as farmers and now it's like 2%, we will have another technological revolution with these machines. We will be able to delegate to them the things we don't enjoy and have a better standard of living. And this will eventually affect everyone, in the same way as phones have changed our way of living all around the world. And the best part is that this is the part that we can imagine now, not the only things that will happen. One day, when the brains of the robots are good enough and the hands are skilled enough, we will have countless teachers, doctors, builders, all you can imagine in the palm of your hand, and without having to invest millions of dollars and hours in the training of all these qualified workers. Right now, you, me, and everyone with an internet connection has access to all the knowledge that humanity has ever created. We can learn everything online, any language, any job, anything you've ever wanted to know. These humanoid robots will be able to apply all this knowledge for you. If you want, you won't even need to learn how to cook, or how to weld, or how to clean your house. They will do it for you, and they will teach you everything else that you want to know, everything else that you enjoy learning. So that we can dedicate our precious time to the things we really want, to raise our children, to learn about the universe, to make new friends, to travel the world, or to simply read all the books you have ever wanted. The internet was just all the theory. Humanoid robots will apply this theory to everything in your life. As always, take care and learn more.